Hello everyone, welcome to online lecture series of electronic devices. This is electronic devices, the subject and its subject code is KEC 301. I am Dr. Sapna Katiyar, professor in electronics and communication engineering department at ABES Institute of Technology, Ghaziabad. This is lecture number 32 and today's topic is P-channel depletion type MOSFET. Let us begin. In today's session, I will be discussing about different types of FETs, metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor, which is a MOSFET, advantages, disadvantages and applications of MOSFET, and then P-channel depletion type MOSFET. See, all of these things, it must be, these are actually the prerequisites. Because you must be aware, if you are studying something, what are the advantages, disadvantages, why it is being like studied, where you are going to use this. So, all of these things are very important. Let us begin one by one. First is the different types of FETs. See, FET is what? FET is field effect transistor, and field effect transistors are of two types. One is junction field effect transistor and other is metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. See, junction field, J is for the junction. Junction field effect transistors is again of two types, N channel and P channel, depending upon the availability of channel. It is a N channel JFET or P channel JFET. But MOSFET, its full form is metal oxide semiconductor field effect transistor. It is of two types. It may be a depletion type MOSFET or it may be a enhancement type MOSFET. In one case, channel is present. In the case of depletion type MOSFET, channel is present, while in case of enhancement type, channel is actually absent. It has to be enhanced. That is the basic difference. Depletion type and enhancement type MOSFETs are again of two types, N channel or P channel. So, here in this session, I will be discussing about the P channel depletion type MOSFET. So, from the name itself, it must be clear to you, if you are talking about P channel, means the channel is made from P type semiconductor and the basic substrate is to be taken as a N. Now, the basics about the MOSFET. As I have already told you, MOSFET, M is for metal, O is for oxide, S is for semiconductor field effect transistor. It is also known as metal oxide silicon field effect transistor. Why? Because silicon is the commonly used semiconductor material, that is why. It is also known as IGFET. IGFET means insulated gate field effect transistor. Why IGFET? In the case of the MOSFET, you are going to study that the gate terminal is isolated from the substrate or body. There is no direct connection. There is an insulation in between. That is why it is known as an insulated gate. MOSFET is operated in both depletion and enhancement mode of operation. As I have already told you, in one case channel is present, while in another case channel is to be enhanced, channel is to be created. It uses N or P type semiconductor. That is why the named as N MOSFET or P MOSFET. And silicon is the main choice of semiconductor which is used for the manufacturing of MOSFET, right? But in some cases, silicon germanium can also be used. You have studied about the elementary semiconductors. You have studied about the compound semiconductors. So, compound semiconductors are also used in a multiple applications. One such example is gallium arsenide. But it is not the preferred one. See, gallium arsenide is the preferred for the other device constructions, but it is not the preferred one in the case of the MOSFET because it does not provide good gate oxides. This is the actually factor because of which it is not preferred one, right? So you must remember which particular material is the preferred and which is not the preferred one. If you see the construction, basic construction of the MOSFET, you can see there is a substrate being taken upon which other like semiconductor is being deposited. Over here you can see there are four terminals. This is gate, this is drain, substrate or body, and this is source. So here you can see, if you are aware with the FET, you can observe that the construction of FET and MOSFET is almost same, but here an oxide layer is deposited. You can see in between gate and the substrate there is an insulation. So here this oxide layer is deposited and it is basically SiO2. It provides the insulation. It acts as an insulator. This provides the insulation, that is why the gate is not directly connected with the substrate, and it is known as IGFET, insulated gate FET. And here, as I have told you, a lightly doped substrate is diffused with a heavily doped. This is heavily doped region. And the common applications, it is commonly used for switching, for amplifying signals, right? And most important, MOSFET is a voltage control device. As if you have already studied BJTs in the previous sessions, previous lectures, and you know that BJT is a current control device, but MOSFET or FET, this is a voltage control device. Here input voltage controls the parameter, so you must remember that this is a voltage control device, or it is a voltage controlled field effect transistor. Now, what are the advantages? You must be curious why to study MOSFET or why to use MOSFET if there is a requirement to utilize in any electronic circuitry. What could be the advantages? Low power consumption. This is a very important advantage. See, if you have to utilize any component, if that component requires very high power or the consumption is very high, that is not going to be beneficial for your designing, for your circuitries, right? So low power consumption, this is a very important advantage. No gate diode, you have seen there is an insulation. So it is possible to operate with a positive or negative gate voltage, right? High drain resistance, because lower resistance of a channel. Channel resistance is very, very low, that is why high drain resistance. The physical size of the MOSFET is also very small. MOSFET size, if you see the size of a MOSFET, if you go to your laboratory and see the size of the MOSFET, that is very small. So physical size is small, that is why it is preferred. High input impedance in comparison to JFET, and high input impedance is only because of the insulation which is being provided in between the gate and the substrate body, right? So this is a very important point. Easier to fabricate. Manufacturer can design MOSFET on a large scale. Its design is not complex. It is very simple. Design is simple. It can be easily fabricated. And the switching speed is also very high, because it is required to be used in the electronic circuitries. If it takes a lots of time to be turned on and off, it is not going to be beneficial for any purpose. So that it gives the high switching speed, very high switching speed, that is why it is a preferred one to use in a electronic circuitry. Some of the disadvantages, definitely there must be certain limitations of the MOSFET. Short life, life is relatively short in comparison to the other components, and it required repeated calibration. If you are using it in any circuitry and you want that your output or the parameters which you are getting, that must be perfect. So it required several calibrations, repeated calibrations. That is actually the limitation. Here a thin oxide layer which is being provided in between the gate and the substrate, it makes the MOSFET vulnerable to avoid the permanent damage. And over voltage makes it unstable by providing, if by any like unwanted situation, unavoidable situation, if over voltage, if it gets over voltage from any point, its function, its behavior will be unpredictable, it will be unstable. So these are the certain limitations for the MOSFET. Some of the common major applications: it acts as a passive element. MOSFET can act as a passive element like resistor, capacitor and inductor. It can be used in a radio frequency application, in designing chopper circuits, regulation of DC motors. So here I have listed some of the common applications for the MOSFET. There is a huge list where the MOSFET can be used. So it is a commonly used component, so you must be able to like explain its working, you must be able to understand it quickly, you must be able to draw the characteristic curve, then only. So these are the advantages, disadvantages and applications. Now comparison between the MOSFET and JFET. See, comparison between MOSFET and BJT you are aware with. Let me tell you one or two more points. BJT is a current control device. MOSFET is a voltage control device. BJT is bipolar. B denotes the bipolar. There the charge carriers are electrons and holes both. While in case of MOSFET, it is a unipolar. Majority charge carriers will be the carriers. It may be electrons or holes. But here let us compare the MOSFET with JFET. MOSFET is a voltage control device, JFET is also a voltage control device, nothing change. MOSFET is unipolar, JFET is also unipolar. You know that MOSFET and JFET, these are the two categories of FETs, field effect transistors. So unipolar, unipolar. In case of MOSFET, oxide layer is present, while in case of JFET, oxide layer is absent. Oxide layer is used where? Oxide layer is used in between the gate terminal and the substrate. There is a layer which provides the insulation. Input impedance is very high due to the presence of layer. Input impedance of JFET is high, but input impedance of MOSFET is relatively high in comparison to the JFET. And the reason is this SiO2 layer. Here drain current decreases as negative gate source voltage is increased, and here drain current decreases with increase in minus VGS. ID, which is the drain current. Drain current decreases in the case of MOSFET because of the recombination, and recombination is because of the influence of negative VGS. That is why drain current decreases. But here drain current decreases due to the narrowing of channel width. When VGS is increased, negative VGS is increased, what happens at a point, channel width is being narrowed down, so the overall channel is being closed, pinch off occurs and no further current flows. MOSFET is less noisy, while JFET is more noisy. So in terms of noise contribution, MOSFET is the preferred one in comparison to the JFET. It is less noisy, it is more noisy. Here temperature coefficient is high in case of MOSFET, while in case of JFET temperature coefficient is low. So these are the various parameters upon which you can compare MOSFET with JFET. And if somebody is going to talk about any parameter, you can give the like relative answer. Because of this particular parameter, JFET is preferred or MOSFET is preferred, right? Now let us discuss in detail about the p-channel depletion type MOSFET. How p-channel depletion type MOSFET looks like, how it behaves. See, in p-channel depletion type MOSFET, a n-type substrate is being taken. On this n-type substrate, p regions have been formed. These two regions have been formed by using p-type semiconductor material, and in between this a channel. This is a channel. Channel is formed in between the source and drain. S is for source, G is for gate, D is for drain, SS is for substrate, or in some cases body is also mentioned over here. Here you can see like a SiO2 layer is being deposited over here. This is the SiO2 layer, oxide layer. Oxide layer is deposited upon this entire surface, and a metallic, this is the metallic contact which is being provided to draw these terminals, source, gate, drain. In some cases, substrate or this body terminal, this is internally connected. So there it can be visualized as a three terminals. So then the three terminals will be source, gate and drain. If substrate is also being taken out, then the four terminals, source, gate, drain or substrate or body, right? So here the two regions which have been created acts as a source and drain. There is a channel in between, and this channel is because of the diffusion, and a thin layer of silicon dioxide SiO2 is being created over here for the entire surface to draw the ohmic contact, right? Now here you can visualize with the required potential, required batteries have been provided over here. What happened? You just try to recall. In case of n-type semiconductor, which is being used to form the substrate, here majority charge carriers are electrons, but holes are in the minority. In this p-type, in this channel, holes are present, and holes will be the carrier over here, right? So when we'll be discussing about the different potentials, you have to explain in this particular manner only. How it behaves, how it varies when you are applying the gate source voltage, different gate source voltage, when you are applying the drain source voltage. When VGS is positive, when VGS is negative, when VDS is negative. See, you have already studied the n-channel depletion type MOSFET, and in p-type, this is just the reverse. The current and voltage polarities have been reversed out. That's just the inverted mode, right? This is the symbolic representation for p-channel depletion type MOSFET. Here you can see this arrow is outward, this arrow. The terminals are gate, drain and source. P-channel depletion type MOSFET, it's working in detail. See, current flows when VGS is less than VT. You can see in this case, n-type substrate is being taken, upon which two regions have been created with a highly doped semiconductors P1, and this is the channel. ID is the drain current. ID is drain current. Here you can see this substrate terminal, the VGS, the potential which is being applied, VGS, VDD, this voltage being applied at the drain terminal. Now what will happen over here, just try to analyze it. If you keep gate positive, first case, let us discuss. What will happen over here? If gate is positive, here in this particular channel, holes are available. Gate is positive, holes are having the positive charge, so holes will be repelled, right? At the same time, when gate is positive, in n-type substrate, the majority charge carriers are electrons. Electrons will be attracted towards the gate terminal. It means now recombination will occur. These holes are pushed out towards the substrate, electrons are attracted towards the gate. So, electron hole pair recombination takes place. Means now what will happen? The drain current will decrease. If you apply negative potential at gate, now what will happen? Because of the negative potential, holes will be attracted towards the gate terminal and majority of holes are already available in the channel. Channel is formed because of these particular holes only. Now, some of the in n-type substrate, the minority charge carriers are what? Holes. Because of this negative potential, these holes will be attracted towards the gate terminal. Are you getting this point? Holes are already available in the channel and because of this negative potential, holes will be attracted towards it. It means whatever the minority charge carriers are available in n-type semiconductor, they will be attracted towards the channel and they are going to increase the concentration of holes in the channel itself. So, now what will happen? Drain current will increase, right? So, this is the representation in the case of the on state, off state, how this MOS will be actually. Transfer and drain characteristic curve for the p-channel depletion type. See, transfer characteristic curve is being plotted in between the VGS and ID, while the drain characteristic curve is plotted in between VDS and ID. VGS is the voltage between the gate source terminal and this is the drain current. What we have discussed till now, just try to recall it. When VGS is 0, gate source voltage is 0, small amount of current flows which is denoted as IDSS. IDSS is when VGS is 0. See, 0 substrate is being shown over here. Now, when VGS is increased in negative, minus, now what is happening? Gate terminal is more negative. Now, gate terminal is more negative, then holes which are in the majority charge, holes which are the minority charge carriers in the substrate, they are also attracted towards the gate. It means they are going to increase the concentration of holes in the channel and the drain current increases. If you increase more VGS, see, this is at the VGS 1. If you increase more VGS, drain current will increase. If you increase more VGS, so this is how in terms of negative on this particular scale. But what will happen? If you keep increasing, then drain current will decrease and at this particular point, it will reduce to 0. At this particular potential, it will be. So, accordingly, you can explain the transfer characteristic curve in all the three different like conditions. Just remember what is going to happen when you are applying the VGS positive and VGS negative, how they are going to vary. Just you have to plot it over here. Now, the second, which is the drain characteristic curve. Drain characteristic curve is being plotted in between the VDS. VDS is the voltage between drain source terminal and ID, which is the drain current, right? You can see over here, when VGS is decreasing, see, this is the case when VGS is 0. When VGS is 0, ideally no current must be flowed. But certain amount of, but this particular reason, this is what the cutoff reason. It is not sufficient to turn on the device. When more negative VGS is applied, you can see the curve. Initially, it increases linearly, but after a certain time, it increases very slowly. You can see here it increases sharply, but after a certain time, there is a very small increase. So, you will be finding this particular curve. If you observe this curve, like more negative VGS is decreasing in this particular manner. If you observe this particular curve, you can just segregate, you can divide it into two halves. one is in between A to B and second is in between B to C. Here you can see a small increase in VDS will increase more the drain current, and in this particular section there is a linear increase, there is a high increase. This is the ohmic reason, right? Here you can see the ohmic reason, and the second in between B and C, where the current increases up to a certain point and there is a very small increase, that is the saturation one. So in between this to this, it is the saturation reason. So you can explain the characteristic curve, the drain characteristic, in three different reasons: how a MOSFET is in the cutoff region, how it behaves it in the ohmic region, how the characteristic curves can be plotted over there, and what is the saturation region. So you must remember all the parameters and you will be able to explain it. Let me just summarize it, what we have discussed today. We have discussed about the various types of FETs, because you have to study the MOSFET. So you must be able to understand what is MOSFET. MOSFET is a type of field effect transistor. There is one more type of field effect transistor, which is JFET. In MOSFET, depletion type, enhancement type, and in both the N channel and P channel, depending upon which type of semiconductor is used for the channel formation. Then we have discussed about the basics of the MOSFET. You must be aware, a simple construction of MOSFET and JFETs looks like quite similar, but the MOSFET is also known as a IGFET. IG is insulated gate field effect transistor. There is an insulation in between the gate and the substrate, right? At the same time, we have discussed, we did the comparison between the MOSFET and JFET on the basis of various factors. How you can compare, in which particular case noise is high, in which particular case temperature varies and all. Then we have discussed about the construction of P-channel depletion MOSFET and drain and transfer characteristic. And I hope all the things are now clear to you. Thank you so much.